All right, everyone, welcome back to the channel. It's been another busy week in the world of Linux, and we've got a lot to cover, from a new kernel release candidate all the way from Japan, to a brand new desktop environment finally hitting stable, and even some big moves in the AI space. So grab your coffee or your tea, settle in, and let's get into it. First up, let's talk about the kernel. Linus Torvalds, speaking at the Linux Plumbers Conference in Japan, has just released the first Linux 6.19 release candidate. Now, what's interesting here isn't just the code, but the context. Linus released this a bit earlier than usual, catching some developers by surprise. A little teaching moment, perhaps, or just the realities of working across time zones. You be the judge. The merge window for 6.19 was unusual. A lot of the work focused on internal cleanups, especially in the VFS layer, using more of the automated compiler infrastructure. But the big story, the one we've all been watching, is Rust. The experiment is officially over. Rust is now a permanent part of the Linux kernel. It's happening. This decision was made at the Kernel Maintainer Summit in Tokyo. Miguel Ojeda, who leads the Rust for Linux project, confirmed it. And this isn't just theoretical. Millions of Android 16 devices are already shipping with a memory allocator written in Rust. Greg Crow Hartman himself has said that Rust drivers are proving to be safer than their C counterparts. This is a massive vote of confidence. The DRM subsystem maintainer even suggested that in about a year, they might start requiring Rust for new graphics drivers. This is a significant shift in the kernel development landscape, and it's going to be fascinating to watch how this plays out. Now, let's talk about distributions, and the big news this week comes from System 76. After years of development, Pop OS 24.04 LTS is here, and with it, the first stable release of the Cosmic desktop environment. This is a complete rewrite. They've moved away from their GNOME-based desktop and built Cosmic from the ground up in Rust, and it looks slick. We're talking a new file manager, a new terminal, a new text editor, even a new app store, all built for Cosmic. The launcher is fast, the tiling is intuitive, and the whole experience feels incredibly polished for a 1.0 release. It's based on Ubuntu 24.04 LTS and powered by the Linux 6.17 kernel. I've been playing around with it and I'm impressed. It feels like a breath of fresh air. And the best part? It's not just for Pop OS. You can get Cosmic on Arch, OpenSUSE, Fedora, and even other operating systems. This is a big deal and a massive accomplishment for the System 76 team. And speaking of desktops, the Linux Mint team has been hard at work on Cinnamon 6.6. This is the version that will ship with the upcoming Linux Mint 22.3 release. The primary focus here is on the application menu. It's been completely redesigned, with options for symbolic or full-color icons, configurable places and bookmarks, and a whole host of visual tweaks. They've also modernized the keyboard handling and the virtual keyboard, and made a bunch of improvements to the Settings app, including a new Thunderbolt module. It's a release focused on refinement and usability, and it's looking really solid. On the hardware front, NVIDIA has released a new production driver, version 580.119.02. This is a bug fix release that addresses some annoying issues. They fixed display corruption on some LG UltraGear monitors, squashed a bug that caused corruption in the X-Plane video game, and fixed a regression that prevented specific display modes from being available. They also fixed an issue with incorrect DPI reporting on monitors like the Samsung Odyssey Neo G9. If you're running an NVIDIA card, this is a recommended update. And finally, let's talk about AI. This is where things get really interesting. The Linux Foundation has just announced the formation of the Agentic AI Foundation, or AAIF. This is a huge deal. They're bringing together some of the biggest names in the industry. We're talking Amazon, Anthropic, Block, Google, Microsoft, and OpenAI to create open standards for AI agents. The foundation is being built around three key projects. First, the Model Context Protocol, or MCP, from Anthropic. This is a universal standard for connecting AI models to tools and data. Thousands of developers are already using it. Second, Goose from Block, which is an open-source AI agent framework. And third, Agents.md from OpenAI, which is a standard for giving AI coding agents project-specific instructions. By bringing these projects under the Linux Foundation, the goal is to ensure that the future of agentic AI is open, transparent, and collaborative. This is a critical step to ensuring that this powerful technology benefits everyone. So, there you have it. a new kernel in the works with Rust as a first-class citizen, a brand new homegrown desktop environment from System 76, a polished new version of Cinnamon, and a major new foundation to guide the future of AI. It's an exciting time to be a Linux user. What are your thoughts on all this? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss the next one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.